Rose at an annual rate of 6.6% in the second quarter, up from 2.6 in the first quarter. This is in line with what private forecasters have recently been expecting, and we ourselves have been looking forward to. Now, we're down to the business of the day. And following that, I think that all the economic signs are pointing to a strong recovery. We also have the second quarter deflator numbers, and they'll demonstrate that we're in control of inflation. But these are just two of the most recent examples. I think the economic game plan is working. As Paul Volcker said on Saturday, we now have a rare opportunity to achieve sustained growth on a firm foundation of stability.
I don't know what he meant by that.
And he means stay the course. What's needed to reinforce the recovery is more determination on the part of all of us to curtail budget deficits by spending control and not by raising taxes. The Democrats' proposal to cap the third year of the tax cut is not only politically misguided, it's substantively wrong. A permanent tax increase would hit not only the wealthy, but significantly millions of middle-income taxpayers, two-year married couples, and 2.4 million small businesses, including 350,000 family farms. As a matter of fact, I know you've seen all of some of the figures, but I used one in Mississippi yesterday. Tip
where?
This magic $50,000, this $50,000 breaking point that they like to point, that $50,000 a year you're automatically up there. Well, if that was true in 1973, then in 1983, that dividing point would have to be $113,843. That's what inflation has done. The magic 50,000 figure doesn't figure at all. It is right back down there with the middle income earners. And 48% of the savings, or the increase, I should say, under the cap, would fall on people below $50,000. A family, husband and wife, the average family, making $32,000 a year, would move from a 33% bracket to 37%. Under TIPS cap. Now, as far as the budget resolution conference report goes, and I have to say I don't think it goes far, I simply have to oppose it. It doesn't control spending, it raises taxes, as the recovery gains force, and it shortchanges our defense rebuilding. And I just, as far as I'm concerned, is totally unacceptable to me. Finally, the conference on the supplemental must significantly scale back the $1.5 billion in domestic add-ons contained in the Senate version. I think a drastic surgery on the domestic side is necessary. It is yes signed. And now, before you all scream and rage, I want to ask Don Reagan to say a few words about his tax cap and Dave Stockman then on the budget resolution before turning to Bob and Howard.
Industry, and all because he invested the gifts of knowledge that God had given him. in a spirit of giving to his fellow man. The principles of impoverish their people. Communism works only in heaven where they don't need it, and in hell where they've already got it. Deregulated financial institutions. We've introduced strong new incentives for individual retirement accounts, extended IRAs to participants in employer-sponsored pensions will be coming up in 1985, when 15% of interest income, up to $450 for single taxpayers and $900 for married couples, can be us all real hope for our future. Dollars in research funds to high-tech firms. The Paperwork Reduction Act, the Regulatory Flexibility Act will help your firms, and you may see none yet. But there's an easier way to tell you Reaganomics. Everything is starting to mesh, just as Americans have spotted it more, so they can spend more. Last year, they gave me their word that there would be $3 in one fell swoop. Funny how they all forgot about that. Well, I haven't forgotten about it, but it takes a greater leap of faith to trust the motivation and wisdom of the self-proclaimed champions of fairness who are now attacking the middle class. And make no mistake, capping the third year would raise taxes on millions of two-earner couples earning less than $50,000. Men make ends meet, would consider itself rich. Let's remember that, just to keep up with inflation, that couple had to double its income in the last 10 years. The couple which earns 35 deserve our freedom and America, the last best rule.